Across the rainbow bridge of Asgard, where the booming heavens roar, you'll behold in breathless wonder.
The great halls of celestial Asgard, a royal voice is raised in protest.
Mighty Odin, all-powerful king of the gods.
Sire, 'tis the Norn queen.
I beg the return of my magical Norn stones, stolen by your god of menace, Loki.
Their powers could be used for evils unbounded.
Bring Loki before me.
I hid them.
Sire, I will fetch the stones and return them to the Norn queen.
Have a care, my son. This day, none can call on me for aid. I will be deep in the sleep of life, the ritual I must endure for one full day each year to preserve my immortality.
Sleep well, my father. The Norn stones will be back with their mystic queen ere you awaken.
You will find them in a pouch beneath that rock.
In that mountain, Loki? You are indeed a fool, hiding those magic stones so near the hidden tomb of the Destroyer.
He will learn which of us is the fool. This very day, while Odin sleeps, I shall achieve my ultimate triumph over Thor.
Ah, that must be the rock. Yes, the pouch. For once my wicked half-brother has spoken the truth.
But even as the Thunder God examines the fabled Norn stones...
Ha! If 'tis to be done, it must be now. That renegade hunter, he shall be my puppet. I have but to control his mind. Look, ahead of you, hunter, the Thunder God himself. What a prize! Shoot, hunter!
The Thunder God. But no, not a mere bullet on such a target. For him, this anesthetic shell, it can stop a herd of elephants.
Yes! Fire! Fire!
The mighty Thor, felled by the one weapon his strength cannot resist, an instant action sleep gas.
Thor, my captive. What does it all mean? The god of thunder. And these Viking relics, too. All within the shadows of that strange mountain bad.
Magic must not go near bad mountain.
Stow that voodoo talk. Somehow I've got a feeling I should investigate that mountain.
Yes, hunter. And my magic will unveil a page from a bygone world.
The whole mountain. The blast wakens Thor.
Oh, no. Not the crypt of the Destroyer. No human must come within arm's length of him.
The dazed hunter stares. Where the bleak mountain had been, a temple or a tomb. Some strange force seems to be drawing me. Unable to resist the eerie attraction of the great structure, the hunter edges slowly, hesitantly, into the silent sepulcher.
Could it be the tomb of that native legend? Of a metal monster without a life of his own, waiting for ages until...
No, he must not know. If he gets within arm's length of the Destroyer, his brain energy will activate it. His very life will be drawn from his body. It is the Temple of Darkness, built by Odin ages ago to hold and hide the life-hungry monster for all eternity. What sinister force exposed it now? If only I am in time.
Closer! Hurry, hunter! Move within arm's length! It is done! The spirit transfer! The life of the man has left his mortal body, and the Destroyer lives again!
That sound? By the stars of Asgard! His body stands rigid. I am too late.
Back, Thunder God! Away from my mortal body!
The Destroyer, you live again!
To do what I was created for!
Destroy! Destroy!
No, by the golden gates of Asgard it must not be. All-wise Odin placed you here to shield humanity from any future danger. You must return to the endless sleep that he decreed. I will stop you. I must.
It is already too late. Even the power of your hammer is as nothing to me.
He speaks true. He has the strength to wield my mighty weapon, and yet, if I fail to stop him here, all Earth will be his helpless prey.
His own mighty Ulu hammer turned against him. How can Thor win? Or even survive.
Danger Channel V.
Aha! My triumph at last! My half-brother Thor will be destroyed by the Destroyer. And those who have scoffed at Loki will change their tune. Dawn Queen, now what do you say? I have released the Destroyer upon Thor.
Have you lost your wits, Prince of Evil? How dare you defy Odin's edict?
What edict?
Look upon my magic mists, the moment recreated.
Verily, I do know Thor's journey doth take him near the crypt of the Destroyer. 'Twas I who buried him neath a granite mountain. And 'tis I who will impose swift death on whoever frees the indestructible menace.
Those were Odin's words within the hour.
And within another, Thor's life will surely end. I cannot stop the Destroyer. Now, only Odin has such power.
And you, Knave, will pay with your life.
No, no! Thor may have a chance. See? He regains his hammer.
It is mine again. But hold. The very earth trembles. What new attack is this?
The bolt of limitless force to disarm you again.
My hammer, sliced in two. I will still battle, even with no weapon.
No, Thor! If you die, then Loki dies. Only Odin can stop the Destroyer.
Halt! It is forbidden. None may enter Odin's chamber.
Silence! You speak to Loki, son of Odin, brother of Thor.
Nay, prince of menace. Though the heavens tremble, Odin's immortality must be preserved by the ritual of the sleep of life.
Back, lords! Will be a death sleep for your thunder god if Odin is not told.
You lie, master of trickery. All Asgard knows your hateful Thor. Plan your wild schemes in here and count the hours till Odin awakens.
I possess every destructive force in the universe. You have no chance, son of Odin.
The Norn stones. Perhaps I can gain advantage with their levitating powers.
I'll put an end to your leaping and dodging with magnetic force to bring you down, and a liquefying force to entrap and hold you.
The liquefied molecules are hard again. I am trapped before him.
If Thor dies, I die too. Somehow I must save him. But even my powers of enchantment cannot melt these walls. 'Tis not fair, not fair. I am doomed, all because of Thor. The Destroyer is beyond me. But if the mind of the hunter still lives within him, perhaps my mental powers can reach him.
You struggle in vain, fool. No power in the universe can loosen those flint-hard molecules.
Struggle is never in vain if it be with honor.
But for you, it ends now.
Hunter, return into your mortal form.
Hey, I am the Destroyer. But your moment of doom can wait, Thunder God, while I inspect my mortal body, for no harm must befall it.
Move closer, closer, within arm's length, and perhaps...
Yes, to this human form I shall return.
Return to your mortal body. I order you, Hunter.
The Destroyer takes orders from none, not even Odin himself. Let him hear how I destroyed his favored son with a bolt of elemental energy.
The tide of irresistible destructive power moves toward Thor, and in one cataclysmic instant, every atom of immortal Thor is gone. Can even the spirit of the great Thunder God survive such total obliteration?
I have destroyed a god. So will I destroy a world.
Nay, Destroyer. For Thor still lives.
How could you survive?
Not even your blast could destroy the Norn stones which I carry.
But it changed your molecular structure. You're not solid. And you are fading. Your life is done.
My atoms are transmuting. My spirit grows weaker. Is my immortal life thus soon to end? I must keep him from gaining the fantastic powers of the Norn stones as well.
But Thor's fading will can carry him no further.
I am undone.
Then, suddenly...
What strange enchantment is this? I live once more a being of flesh and sinew.
Magic!
It could only come from Asgard. But with Odin deep in the sleep of life, who else would send me strength? Who? Look, he lies prostrate.
The strain was too great. Could not control the hunter, but the force of my thoughts held Thor. I'm sure of it. But I cannot stop the Destroyer.
It is a madness that is upon him.
Odin must be awakened. Tell someone. Someone.
Aye, a madness indeed.
The Norn Queen. Yes, I must reach her.
Like a living but wearying thing, Loki's thought energy crosses the barren netherlands of Asgard toward the land of the mystic Norns.
Queen of Norns. You must awaken Odin from his sleep. It is your only chance to recover the Norn stones, Majesty. Remember, if Thor dies at the hand of the Destroyer, Odin's wrath will smite you as well.
You fear but for your own life, thief of our treasure. But go, I will give thought to the matter.
Hurry, hurry!
Meanwhile...
Somehow, I must live to thwart his unspeakable plan.
Here is the fiery death.
Enough of this fleeing like a scared rabbit. Am I not Thor, son of Odin? His may be a strength beyond measure, but now he'll learn what power Thor can summon.
Ah, a puny effort.
Powers of darkness, heed your queen's command.
A vision touches Odin's sleep. The royal lips speak just one word.
Thor.
I must fight him with my wits. My only weapon against him may be his own mortal body.
What? Oh, no.
Yes. If you strike at me now, you will destroy your own mortal body.
Ah, do not be so sure, fool.
A dream has told me of dire peril to the god of thunder. Let it be visible to me now as well. What monumental disaster is this? Hear me, Thor!
Odin!
Stand away, god of thunder. Only Imperial Odin has the power to halt the invincible destroyer.
Nay, my father, I must wage my own battle, no matter what the cost. But Thor does not plan to perish. I shall fight him with the spirit transfer.
No! No!
Within one arm's length, the spirit must return, just as it left the mortal body.
No.
Hunter, I have saved you from a destiny of terror.
Saved?
A terror that must never threaten the world again. The menace will be buried beyond mortal reach forever.
But don't you even blame me?
Nay, you are but a pawn. In all the universe, there is only one being with the power and will to have done this thing.
Loki! But Loki must not go unpunished.
Noble father, since all began with his theft of the Norn Queen's treasures, it would be a fitting penance if he were bonded into her servitude for a goodly period.
Wise words, my prince. So be it.
For your return of the Norn Stone, we do indeed offer our gratitude, Thunder God.
Cross the rainbow bridge of Asgard, where the booming heavens roar, you'll behold in